Good morning, students. Welcome to e-learning class of social science. Today we will read lesson 3 of geography, movements of the earth. In ancient time, people studied the movement of the sun, star and planet in the sky. They thought the shape of earth was flat and it was stationary. All heavenly body were moving around the earth. Nicolaus Copernicus said that earth is not a stationary and it is also not the center of universe. According to him, the earth has two types of movement. One is spinning around its axis and second is moving around the sun. So earth has two types of movement, rotation and revolution. Now I am telling you about rotation of earth. What is the rotation of earth? Rotation is the movement of earth on its axis. Earth ka apne axis par ghumna. Look at the picture. Rotation kehlata hai. Period of rotation. The earth takes a time of about 24 hours to complete one full rotation. The period of rotation is known as the earth day. This is the daily motion of the earth. The axis of the earth which passes through the pole is inclined at an angle 23.5 degrees from the vertical. This tilt of the earth axis is known as inclination of earth axis. The speed of earth rotation around its axis is maximum at the equator. This is a equator which is largest parallel. It is about 1617 kilometer per hour. The north pole, this is north pole, and the south pole are actually point. So the speed of rotation at the pole is zero. The effects of earth rotation. Day and night is caused by the rotation of earth. The rotation of earth also caused the bulging of earth near equator and flattening near the poles. The regular occurrence of high tide and low tides twice a day is also due to the rotation of earth. Now I am telling you about revolution of the earth. The movement of the earth around the sun in a fixed path or a orbit is called revolution. This is a orbit of the earth. The axis of earth, which is an imaginary line, makes an angle of 66.5 with its orbital plane. The plane formed by the orbit is known as orbital plane. When the earth is nearest to the sun, it is said to be perihelion. The distance is about 147 million kilometers and may occur on 3rd January, when the earth is furthest from the sun, it is said to be aphelion. The distance is about 152 million kilometer and may occur on 4th July. The time taken by the Earth to complete one revolution around the sun is about 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes and 45 seconds, or about 365 1 by 4 days. This is known as a year. To accommodate the additional 1/4 day each year, every 4th year is taken as a leap year of 366 days. Effects of the revolution. Number 1, varying the length of day and night. Second, changing season. Let us study the four position of the Earth during its revolution around the sun. The summer solstice, the winter solstice, the spring equinox and autumn equinox. The summer solstice occur on 21 June when the North Pole is inclined toward the sun. Northern hemisphere experience summer season and southern hemisphere experience winter season. The winter solstices occur on 22 December when the South Pole is inclined towards the sun. The southern hemisphere experience summer season and the northern hemisphere experience winter season. The spring equinox on 21 March, it is spring in the northern hemisphere and autumn in the southern hemisphere. The autumn equinox on 23 September, it is autumn in the northern hemisphere and spring in the southern hemisphere. Let's recall, rotation is the movement of Earth on its axis. It causes day and night, and revolution is the movement of Earth around the sun. It causes season. Thank you. Have a nice day.